Scientists have created a novel snake antivenom, but the antibodies were not created in a lab. They came from a Wisconsin truck mechanic who injected so much venom into his body that it became a research and development laboratory. And now his immune system could be the source of a major snake antivenom revolution. Which is pretty cool because there's a shockingly large number of people who die from snake bites. But before we understand how this works, we need to understand how we got here. And what sounds like a Marvel origin story? A man named Tim Friede is documented as injecting himself with venom 856 times. I had thought that everyone who wore Slayer t-shirts had injected themselves with venom in the garage, but apparently he was the first. So, why isn't he dead? At one point he flatlined and went into a coma for 4 days, but this only made him more determined to keep going. Inside of Tim's body, a raging battle was taking place. And as he increased the number of venom injections, his immune system refined itself and created better antibodies to neutralize the venom. But even with this superpower, snake bites don't feel great, and he can be seen maintaining his composure after being bit twice by a black mamba. But the medical community supported him, with one doctor saying, "He's a public relations nightmare. There is absolutely no medical benefit to doing this." But Tim didn't care, and he would go on to become the face of antivenom research. But first, we need to understand the science of snake venom. Have you ever wondered how your muscles contract? A receptor sits on the cell membrane, acting like a door lock. A substance called acetylcholine acts like a key and opens this lock. This allows ions to flow through the door, resulting in muscle contraction. We know this is true because this is an actual receptor, and ions normally flow through this tube. And this is black mamba neurotoxin. It prevents the door from opening so that no ions can travel through it. This results in flaccid paralysis, where you stop breathing and you can die fully conscious, unable to move or speak. But what if we could mop up the snake venom? This is one of Tim's antibodies binding to black mamba neurotoxin. Now the toxin can no longer bind to the receptor and the patient can survive. A company called Centivax hired Tim because his blood was a gold mine, and they began the work of finding his most promising antibodies. There are multiple toxins in snake venom, so they chose three promising candidates. Their 2025 paper was pretty lit, and they got partial or full protection from 19 of some of the baddest snakes on the planet. But to understand why this is such a big deal, we need to learn about our current standard of care. Antivenom is old technology. It was invented in 1895 by Albert Camus. It involves injecting venom into horses and then using their antibodies. But stuff in horses isn't really supposed to be in humans, and this can cause anaphylaxis, which is not a vibe. And it gets worse. The antivenom has a very particular set of skills. And if I don't have the right antivenom for the right snake, I won't be helped. And this isn't great, because people often forget to take selfies of their snakes after they get bitten, and so their doctor doesn't know what venom to use. And when Western medicine doesn't help people, they start to turn to other types of doctors. But Tim's antibodies were broadly resistant to multiple types of snakes because they had been refined over the years. And this means you don't even need to know what type of snake bit you in order to be helped. And we will no longer need horses. We can manufacture these antibodies in bioreactors, so you'll be significantly less likely to suffer from anaphylaxis. And the antivenom can be freeze-dried, meaning we don't need to store it in an expensive refrigerator. We can put the antivenom in remote locations to decrease the time between snake bite and treatment. Initial trials will take place on people's pets that have accidentally been bitten by snakes. And if everything goes well, human trials will begin and lives will be saved. Do you have any videos you'd like me to do in the future? Let me know in the comments. And remember to like and subscribe to support me.